Gentlemen, this is the 12-14 starting half from Auburn University, Michael Johnson. Bomb. Four plate. Bomb.
Johnson, Michael here to play second shot, here to par 5 first. Third shot from Michael at the par 5 opening hole. Hole was cut today, 12 paces on, 4 from the right. Starting to pick up. That's underneath the hole. It's spinning away from it. Michael from birdie at the first. Get to 3 under par. Opened up to 2 under par, 7 yesterday. Johnson for par at first to stay at minus 2. Johnson now on the tee with a 339-yard par 4 second. Did not take advantage of a par 5 opener. Still 2 under for the championship. Reese is getting stronger once again. Michael Johnson playing his second shot now to the second. And just like at the opening hole, a pin is located 12 paces on and 4 from the right. Underneath the hole again, just like at the previous hole. MJ for birdie at the second, get to 3 under. His Virginia playing partner, Danny Walker, found the creek with his second shot. After finding the fairway bunker off the tee. Well, I got this putt to the hole. This would remain at 2 under par for the tournament championship. That's about difficult par three. Might go on the tee at the third. Flag is on 19. And five from the left. And the breeze continues to stiffen here. Second shot for Johnson at this third. Good news is he's got some green to work with. He's got some work left to remain even par for the second round. Jay for par at the third. Stay at 2 under for the weekend. Bogey putt to drop to 1 under. Johnson out here, the 357-yard par 4-4. Team members all the way back today. Yesterday aerial movement, some 20 yards. Left. There's the approach from Michael at the fourth. Hole case today. 8 on and 13 from the left. It's a false front and extends about 5 paces into the green. For birdie here at the fourth. Get back to minus two. Michael for par at the fourth. Staying at 1 under. AJ on the team out of 403-yard, our 45th hole. It's 1 over in the second round, 1 under for the championship. Second shot for Michael here at fifth. Flag today. 29 on, 6 on the right. This was one of the hardest holes on the course in yesterday's opening round. Cannot come up short here. Or go long. That's probably going to be Michael's best shot of the round so far. Johnson for birdie, 50 to get up to minus 2. birdie of the day for Michael. Back to 2 under. There's a whole location at 6 today. 18 on and 5 from Michael's left. Cannot miss left, because left is a watery grave. Michael's coming off his first birdie of the day. Back at the 5th. Get back to even par for that second round. Side of the green. That's going to be a tough 2-putt from there. That's not far from where yesterday's hole location was. We are back to par 36. See the pond, which guards green to the left and short. MJ has a long 30 putt here at 6. For back to back. Slow down. Last year in the second round, he made double bogey 5 here to his name short bogey putt. Michael sucks up his par putt here. 6. Great 2-putt from Michael. Stays at 2 under. Michael, the 2-to-417 par 4 7 hole. Coming off a big par save 6. .275 to reach that bunker down the right side. That's probably over 300. The location is 7. That's 10 on and 3 from Michael's right. Big drive we get here. Long. Well. Michael has a birdie opportunity here at the 7th, albeit a fairly long putt after the long drive he hit on this hole. See if he can get it to 3 under for the championship. Actually a good score here, number 7. Starting with the short par 4 8th. Michael on the tee at a 342-yard par 4-8. He still moved up 11 yards today. Hole location at 8 today. 21 on and 4 from Michael's left. Second shot. Misread it. To the par 5 ninth hole. MJ is now on the tee at a 540-yard par 5 ninth. Still even par for the day. Deter him from reaching this green in two. That's out to the right. Nothing good over there. Looks like Michael's getting some relief, possibly from the cart path. This is his second shot here at the par 5 ninth, and the 1225 group behind is already standing on the tee box. House in the background. So Michael plays his third shot to par 5 ninth. Flag today, 12 on, 13 to the right. Golf course here. There's Auburn. There's Michael. That's for birdie at 9. 6. Short. Well, the next hole's a par 5. A scenic par 5 at that. Should start to stretch along Lake Windward, where anything can happen. Michael Johnson now at the 607-yard par 5 11th, the longest hole here at the Golf Club of Georgia. And that too is in the fairway. Michael's second shot here at 11. Michael. And here's what we'll have left. Hole case today, 24 on and 4 from the right. Here's the flag at 11 today, 24 on and 4 from the right. It's Michael's right. At least he went behind to the right, it was green, like Windward. Not where you want to be. So James third shot. left of the 74-yard par 4 12. Looks like that's down the left side of the fairway, right at the fairway bunkers. Here to 12th hole. Michael Jones getting a simple shot. Flags at A. Six on and four from the right. That's not what MJ was looking for. Comes a little short. That was a good day to be on a boat, although a little breezy. Michael Johnson is ready to put for birdie here to 12. Johnson for par at 12. Staying 2 under par. Remains even on moving day. Johnson now on the tee at a 183-yard par 313. I think it's the far right tee box today. Location 21 paces on it, 10 paces from the left. Short from the left, and get wet. Johnson for birdie here at 13. Not had a birdie since the 5th hole today. Has had several good looks and a birdie. Still even for today. Michael tee to 432-yard par 414. Toughest hole on the course yesterday. Put up that right pin. Side of pins front left. Location at 14 today. 7 on and 4 from Michael's left. This is his second shot. He was coming out of the right rough, so probably couldn't put a whole lot of spin on it. That golf ball you see closest to the hole, that's UCLA's Jonathan Garrick. There's another boat out in the lake. Michael just slammed his golf bag again in frustration. Did not like that shot he just played here to par for 14th. That's a very long birdie putt. This should do well to two putt. And a birdie putt for 14. He's working on a string of 8 consecutive pars. Looks like it's going to be 9 consecutive pars since the birdie on 5. Up here, lakeside. 9 pars in a row for Michael. 4 holes left on moving day, Saturday, here at the USCC. Here's where the flag is located today on 15. Just like on the previous hole, 7 on and 4 to Michael's left. Michael's tee shot found the fairway. 401-yard par for 15th. This catches a piece of the front right corner. Michael Johnson for a birdie at 15 to break this par streak. This is now at 9 holes in a row. Minus 3. Looks like it's going to have 10 pars in a row. For Michael, still even par. First round today, 2 under for the championship. Michael Johnson, 10 par for 16. Approach with Michael Johnson here at 16. Hole located today, 34 on and 4 from the left. Left of the hole. Right now it's 5 o'clock Eastern Daylight Time. Auburn is leading the U.S. Collegiate with Michael's teammate Will Long leading individually at minus 8. Michael's at minus 2, currently tied for 12th, looking to get to 3 under. It's been that kind of day for Michael. It's a tough par 3 ahead, which I would bet is playing as the hardest hole today. And then the par 5 18th, which surprisingly was the easiest hole on the course yesterday. Jones is par at 16th, standing 2 under, and this would be his 11th consecutive par today. Seven straight pars and 2 holes left. MJ Mathers to get a 226-yard par 3 17th. Last couple of years, they've moved this tee up to that back left hole location, but not this year. And speaking of the hole, it's 36 long and 6 on the left. The left is no good here, as there is a pond over there. So now for par 17, this will be for 12 pars in a row. Still minus 2. Championship. As long as we experience things, we special when the flag is back left as it is today. Michael now to the 564-yard par 5 finishing hole. This was the easiest hole in the opening round yesterday. Normally that honor belongs to the par 5 first hole on the front side. To be straight down the middle. Second shot from Michael Johnson to par 5, 18th. I'd imagine this is a layup. That was a layup. This is what he's going for his next shot. Hole location today, 11 on and 8 from his left. Here's the hole location at 18. Once again, 11 on, 8 from Michael's left. The golf ball you see to the left of the hole is the result of Jonathan Garrick's second shot. We have an eagle putt. Michael wanted to hole this shot out for an eagle. So this is his third. Trying off the par trains at 12 pars in a row since break at 5. sighted a hole there. For a round of 1 under 71, at 2 rounds on over 3 under 141. In a row, and around the par 72 to stay at 2 under, and finish at 142. Michael for par and around the even par 72 to post 2 under 142 for 2 days with 1 day left. Par is 1 and 2, bogeys 3, pars 4, birdies 5, and then 13 pars in a row to finish. Back in the lead. Auburn is now finished. So Michael Johnson just came in. Jonathan Kepler's team, Florida State, in third. They were the overnight leaders. Texas in 10th. Clemson in 6th. Georgia Tech has fallen to a tie for 11th. Oklahoma State tied for 13th. With LSU, the reigning SEC champions. And UCLA and Iowa round out the top, the bottom two. In play, not bad. Third shot now for MJ at first. Flag today, cut back left, 38 along at 7 from the left side. Cannot miss it to the left. Out to the right of the hole. Johnson for birdie at the first, hit the 3 under. That's first birdie, par 5. Thank you. still birdie less than a par 5 this weekend, so we'll see. 2 under. Linwood Parkway in the background here. Six guys to the open 339 yard. Par 4 second. Michael on the tee box. He's tied for third. And par 4 scoring as we play 4 under par. Second shot to the second hole located today. 24 on and 5 from the right. Left of the hole. Not a bad shot. Michael Fabry at the second, take to minus. Thompson on the tee at 192 yard, par 3 third. In today, the front right, 5 pieces on, 6 pieces from the right. 8 bogey here yesterday. And par on Friday. Great chance at a birdie. Let me change the hole. One from right here to third. Some egg scoops on the tee box. On top of the hill. The other two have been scrambling in this group. Del Solar just made bogey. And Paul just made par. Michael did a 1 bag. Our streak has been snapped. Moves to 3 under. After that nice birdie at the last, Michael's now a tee for 357 yard par 4. Frost's cleared the fairway. Approach the fourth. Flags Bay is 23 on. 5 from the right edge. Back-to-back birdies. Johnson for back-to-back birdies here at the uphill. 4-4-4-4. for MJ. So you get 3 under for the weekend. Now he heads off to the fifth hole where he made birdie yesterday. Michael Johnson on the tee with a 406-yard par 4 fifth hole. Mr. Johnson's approach here to fifth. Holes in the front and left today. First time it's been on the left side of the green all weekend long. It's 5 on and 6 from the left. Birdied this hole yesterday. Paul McBride just had a great approach in here before him. Doing the same thing Paul's did. So he'll have that to birdie 2 of his last 3 holes to get to 4 under. Right. Some birdie putt from Michael. So 2 of the last 3 holes. He's now got it up to 4 under par. 2 under on the final round today. Second shot at the 8th. Flags on 14 and 3 from his right.
Alright. Nice. Alright.
I've got a... Michael for 38 to leave. Get to minus 5. Turns out all the footage on the 7th hole that he saw on 8 was not of Michael Johnson, it was of Jacob Solomon. And then slides by. Michael went to save par from the trees at 7. Great chance we missed there. And a par putt for Johnson. Off to the par 5 ninth.
65, 64, 129.
Wow.
And the next week.
Johnson on the tee at the final at 40-yard par 5 ninth. Yesterday he missed it to the right and then missed a birdie putt. This should be straight down the fairway today. Location at 9 today. It's 29 on at 6 on the right. And Michael Johnson going to play a second shot. Going for the green in 2. Just stays there. Well, I have an eagle putt. Michael Johnson for eagle with the 9th. Go out in 432. get his first birdie on a par 5 this weekend. And move Michael to 5 under for the championship. Mountain 3 under 33. Michael on a 2 under 446 yard. Par 4 10th. On 10 today. 6 on, 5 from the left. Michael's left. There's Michael's approach. It appears to be coming out of the left rough. And that is short. He's 3 under on a day. So Michael's 6 on 10. Chip. Michael now has this par attempt here at the 10th. Keep this good ground going. It's par 5 that follows this hole. Starts to stretch along way to the north. From over to 10. So his first of the day, and possibly his first on a par 4 this weekend. Michael Johnson taking off a 607-yard, par 5, 11. Longest hole at Gulf of Georgia. I guess I'm not too thrilled about that tee shot. Double bogey at the 10th. Michael has pulled another drive into the left rough here. Set the 607-yard par 5 11. Coming off 6 of 10.
Another pretty tough hole location.
And it's 21 on and 3 from the left. Michael's third shot at the 11. 3-1 for the final round. Johnson on the tee now with 374 yards, par 412. Shots now to the left. Come on back. Gets hung up there. Unfortunate. 12th man. Mike Winward to the right. Michael Johnson is right here. From Michael, stays with 2 under. Birdied this hole last year in the final round. First, we've seen today. A pretty punt here. 13, you have got to 4 for the championship. This will be the second par 3. He's birdied today. This goes in. Got it. On the 432-yard par 14th. And off birdie at the 13th. Get back to 400 for the championship. There's the flag sound, 14, back left. Sign here at 14. Michael Johnson getting ready to putt for birdie at 14. This would be for back to back. Michael Penn for birdie. Let's get back to 5 under. Oh. Par is actually a good score here at 14. For Johnson, he had minus 4. So he's going to stay at minus 4 for the championship. So let's find out. Flag on 15 today, 27 on and 4 from the players, right? MJ hit ready to hit his approach. Social product for 2 minutes. Thank you. location at 16. 21 paces on, 6 paces from the left. Michael has pushed his drive into the right rough here. It is uphill par 4. Sort of relatively good angle though, albeit not in the fairway. Third shot from Michael at 16. Two of the putters from just the back of the green. Still above the hole, but not a bad try. MJ to save par at 16. Should keep his championship score 4 under. Still 2 under on J despite a double at 10. Birdies at 3, 5, 9, and 13. And that's huge. Out 17, 7 on, 7 from Michael's right. Team markers are moved way forward, from, but still playing from the back tee. Michael's tee shot. 2 under on the par 3s today, 33 and 13, par at 6. Hardest hole on the course, the first 2 rounds of 3-17. Has a par putt here at 17. Staying at 4 under. Stays at minus 4 for the championship. 1 hole left. Michael on the tee at 5 at 64 yard par 5 finishing hole, or 54th hole of the championship. doesn't like it. The flag at 18, 20 on, and 4 for the player's right. Michael Johnson, I'm guessing his second shot. Michael for Eagle. The final round 468. We can put him at 600, 210 for the championship. Goodbye. All right.